and that he was appointed on the basis, on the table of transparency, accountability, and fair play. That he indicated when he was elected, it was an exceptional journey. And what I really was impressed when you mentioned that you met so many beautiful people along the way. And it is so important that we appreciate the human aspect of the sport in terms of meeting persons of caliber, persons with passion for the game of football. So again, I want to welcome you, and of course, we have next to you, of course, our Minister of Sport, who of course is a former footballer of one of our big teams and captain of the big teams, you know. Yeah, so welcome. Thank you. How has it been?
Thank you, Vice President. It's an honor to be here with you. It's a great pleasure to be here in this beautiful country, in this football country, with these young players as well, and the older ones too. But everyone shares the same passion. I was saying to David, who's a great guy as well, one of these beautiful persons who share this passion for the game. I was telling him, coming from the airport, residents here, I see many football pitches around. I see many kids and so on playing and enjoying the game, and this is what we have to do. Unfortunately, I came to FIFA in a difficult period for FIFA, but this is a new FIFA now. There's a new CONCACAF, there's a new Trinidad and Tobago Football Association. There are many people around the world, like you, who love football.
Yes,
indeed. Who have a passion for football, wants to do something for football. And, maybe some of our predecessors, some people who were there, forgot a little bit our mission.
They lost their focus.
Exactly.
Yes.
Which is to develop football, which is to make these kids, but also those who are less talented than them, play, enjoy, because football is much more than just a sport. It brings so many values. It teaches you to play in a team. It teaches you to win. It teaches you to lose as well. And it gives you so much that we have to work on that. So I'm very happy to be here and help.
But I think one thing that is very instructive is that, you know, you represent academia and sporting excellence. You're a lawyer by profession, and you happen to be born in the same month as I am, in March.
Next month, sir.
Yes, I agree. You know, and I think it's a signal to all and sundry that sports and education can work hand in hand and walk hand in hand. And work hand in hand and walk hand in hand. And of course, most of these young men, of course, are attending, hoping to go to university soon. So I'm really, really happy that you are displaying in real terms that kind of, you know, holistic dispensation in terms of who you are, in terms of what you aim to achieve. And more importantly, that you are hoping for a transparent, accountable FIFA. I think one thing I'm very happy about is, as you try to wear the federations from the minor countries in the world, I mean, we do have economic challenges. And I'm very pleased to see that it's your intention to contribute some $4 million to each federation. It's excellent. I look at what you've been saying about youth initiative in the Caribbean. In fact, I don't know if I could probably sell a particular thing to you as we now speak, because I am a very strong advocate of youth empowerment.
Yeah.
And of course, you're quite aware that we have the Caribbean Cup for senior players. And a few years ago, I mentioned it to the authorities, and of course, I want to mention it again to you. Why not have, for example, a Junior Caribbean Cup for the best colleges team playing in a round-robin tournament in a particular island, the same way it's done with the Caribbean Cup? You know, you have the knockouts, and that way we'll be able to showcase our young players, because we do have excellent young players in the Caribbean region. And of course, as you're quite aware, it's about access, it's about opportunity,
yeah.
It's about being visual. And I feel a competition of that nature will show you the magic that we have in the Caribbean.
President, this, it's a very interesting proposal. First of all, because, as you rightly said as well, when we speak about football development and education, we have to be aware that it's not just about training the sporting skills of a boy or a girl, but we educate persons as well, all together. You, the school system, the education system, and the football system can contribute and has to contribute to that. And therefore, whatever can be done in conjunction with the college and the school system is certainly something positive that we have to support the system. When it comes to your proposal, it's indeed an interesting one, and actually it fits into something that we have started to put in place, because when I was campaigning, it was actually the first time I came to Trinidad and Tobago to try to convince this gentleman to support my vision, which I think he did.
Which I know he did.
So I thought as well that, you know, we have to support competitions being played, youth competitions being played. And for this reason we have allocated, for the first time in FIFA's history as well, an amount, $1 million every year to the regional competitions, like for example Caribbean, in order to be able to get an opportunity for these kids, for these boys and girls to play. Therefore, I think that a proposal like this can certainly be looked at together with the associations in the region. And why not? Because they need to compete. Indeed. And as I was saying, you know, if you are an island, and you are of course a leading country, you're not a minor country, as you were saying in football terms, you are one of the leading countries, certainly the leading country in the region. If you are an island,
you're warming my heart here.
No, I'm completely objective.
Yes.
I'm Swiss.
Yes.
Now, when I speak about football, Italian. Yes. No, but you know when it's true, when you are an island, and you want to progress playing football, you have to compete. If you have to compete, you have to play against somebody else. And if you are an island, you know you have basically two choices, you swim or you fly. To swim is a bit dangerous, to the next island, fly costs money. Yes.
The thing is, in fact, as much as, for example, I may be focusing on Trinidad and Tobago, I'm really focusing on the wider Caribbean nation.
Yes.
Because
yes.
I view myself as a Caribbean man, and I feel that we have particular strengths in the Caribbean, and in that regard, there is also a need for greater assistance in some of the smaller countries, mm-hmm. because some of the countries are as not as developed as the latter countries. And then you have issues. For example, I think Haiti, for example, stands out as a peculiar country in the Caribbean where we need to engage in greater proactive social transformation. And I think this can be done through sport. You know, and certainly Haiti has in fact been knocking on the door for some time. You know, in the context of resources, facilities that they require, and I think in that regard, you know, FIFA can also help individually and regionally.
Yeah. Definitely, I mean, we need a coordinated approach there as well, and if football can contribute a little bit today, especially today in this world which is going a bit nuts.
Yes.
But the other thing, we can help maybe a little.
The other thing is, if I don't know if in fact you can use your influence to encourage top teams in Europe to come to play in the Caribbean during the off season.
Yeah.
Because I know this is an inclination for the top teams to go to China, Asia, to America.
Yeah.
And they haven't been coming down our side. So, so I mean, we do exist.
Yeah.
And certainly we would like to see top quality football possibly playing against a regional team or even a national team, you know. So I'm just wondering if maybe that this is something you could consider when you're interfacing with the leaders of football in Europe and in England.
Well, definitely we have to, break down these borders which have been created, unfortunately, a little bit in the past as well, for several reasons. Now, of course, today we have other issues, the calendars are congested and so on and so forth, but we still need to be able to create these connections, and I've already started to speak to the European associations, to the European clubs, in particular, to make sure that we are much more open generally.
Well, you know, Mr. Infantino, the thing is, I have brought young people here today because I want to get a message of inspiration from you. Because was it always your intention to get into football? Could you tell us about yourself? Because the young people are here. Because, for example, I mean, you became a lawyer.
Yes.
You know, who inspired you?
Well, you know, I don't know. I when I was at primary school, actually, that's a teacher from primary school who said it after I was elected president of FIFA. About it. And he took out, I was maybe 10 years old, and we had to write in primary school an essay, you know, like, what would you like to become when you are big? And I wrote, apparently, and he has the proof, I wrote, well, I would like to become a professional football player. But if it doesn't work out, because unfortunately my skills are quite bad, then I would like to become a lawyer. And actually, at the end of the day, I became a little bit of both. So I entered football. I was infected by the football virus when I was small, through my father. I always wanted to do something in football.
So your parents played a major role in your life?
Definitely. Yes. Yeah. Definitely. Very major role. Giving me, I think, the values of life, which is, you know, the commitment, the work, the passion, believe in yourself. Believe in yourself is what I can say to all the kids. Believe in yourself. Work. Even if you fail, continue to work, because one day you will reach. You will make your dream true. Dream.
And but in the context of a potential footballer, because of course I know some of these young men hoping one day to play professional football. What would be your advice to them?
To work hard. To work hard, to believe in yourself, to be there, you know, half an hour before the others and to leave half an hour after the others, to train, never to give up. And you know what is the good thing of football, actually? That's actually more than just a sporting element, it's a mindset, I think. Which is, in football, you lose a game, or no, you win a game, you are in a good mood until the next game. You lose a game, you are in a bad mood for one day, and then you focus on the next game. And you want to win the next game. So this is the mentality you must have. Going forward, always looking at the next challenge and trying to win the next challenge.
And that is very good advice, because you know I recall